In order to use a lathe, we need to understand what it is and what are its basic parts. Wikipedia states, "A lathe is a tool that rotates the workpiece on its axis to perform various cutting operations, so to create an object with symmetry about an axis of rotation." So, according to the definition, the first area we should get familiar with is the toolpost. It's the place where we mount the cutting tools that we'll be using to shape the object. In order to move the toolpost along the X and Y axis, it needs to be mounted on two slides, the cross slide and the top slide. Both are operated by hand wheels. The top slide is able to rotate around the vertical axis, allowing the operator to move the cutting tool diagonally in relation to the axis of rotation of the piece. The cross slides are planted onto the carriage, the main slide that moves parallel to the object for the entire length of the workable area. This happens by rotating the main hand wheel, which is attached to the lead screw. Next, we have the motor, the heart of the lathe. It's powered by two switches in the front panel, allowing the operator to power it on and reverse the direction of rotation. On the left side, we find the gears. They connect the rotary motion of the motor to the self-centering chuck, the device that allows us to clamp the workpiece onto the lathe. For automated operations such as cutting threads, we can activate the feed handle. This connects the motor to the lead screw, automatically moving the carriage and the cutting tool along the workpiece. The direct relation between the piece rotation and the cutter motion allows us to create accurate threads, or more simply, to work the piece evenly. To modify the pitch of the thread, between metric and imperial for example, all we need to do is check the gear table posted on the front of our machine. Each pulley has a different number of teeth, and by setting them up as specified on the table, you can obtain a predetermined carriage speed to achieve a specific thread pitch. Last but not least, we have the tailstock assembly. Here we can mount an additional chuck for drilling operation, or a dead center, a stabilizing device used to minimize chatter on longer workpieces.